Hello, everybody. It's 1:30 and it is Friday. And guess who? It's me, Rob. Yes, Rob, with your live quiz today. Yes, normally it's Dylan, isn't it? Dylan's got the day off and it's my turn to do the quiz. So hopefully I will do it properly for you. Thank you very much for watching. It's so good to see you watching me, Rob, with the live quiz from BBC Learning English. How are you doing today? Feeling good? The sun's shining here. It feels like summer at last, which is great and has put us in a good mood for the Friday quiz. Excuse me, already losing my voice. That's not very good, is it? Okay, so as you know, every Friday we do this live quiz and we have eight questions for you. Eight wonderful questions testing you on your knowledge of the English language. There'll be questions to do with spelling and grammar, punctuation, and all kinds of things. Eight questions for you, okay? All about English. Have a go. Don't worry if you get them wrong. Just have a go. It's all about having fun. And that's the main thing about this live quiz, that it is just for fun. Yes, no prizes, I'm afraid, apart from taking part and having fun. You may also get your name here on the screen, because this is the important thing, very important. Take notice. I want you to like, comment, and share this quiz. Tell your friends all about it, because the more people who take part, the more fun we can have, the more we can share our scores and our knowledge. And of course, I'd just like to find out where you are in the world. What's your name? Where are you watching from? How are you getting on with the quiz? Do that kind of thing. So send me your messages, send me your comments, and please do share and like as well. Thumbs up. Okay. Tell everybody that Rob's quiz was amazing. Okay. So like, comment, and share. That's the main thing. Eight questions. Have fun. No prizes. Like, comment, and share. Now, the way we do this quiz is you have your eight questions first. You have time to think about them. And then later on, I will give you all the answers that you need. Okay, so eight questions to come first. Now, one of those questions will come from a special guest. I wonder who that guest is going to be. I wonder who it'll be. You'll have to stay watching to find out who our special guest is going to be. Okay, good. Now, the other thing is that each week our quiz has a bit of a theme to help you with your questions and give it a bit of a theme. And this week's theme is one very close to my heart. It is all about nature, the wonderful natural world that we live in. That's the animals and the plants and the trees. That is nature. So we're going to talk about nature. Do you like nature? Do you like being outside in the countryside, in the fresh air? Are there any wild animals you particularly like? Little insects maybe, or big elephants or anything like that? Nature is an amazing thing. And that's what the theme of our quiz is all about. So tell us what you think about nature as well. But the most important thing is to have a go, send me your comments and send me your messages. And already I can see all your messages coming in. So thanks so much. What have we got here? Hello from Girona in Spain. What a lovely city that is. So hello to Girona in Spain. Thank you for your message. What do you got here? I love nature. Well, that's perfect because this quiz is all about nature. What else we've got? Sharindi says, yes, I like nature too. Well, that's good. That's good. Saeed says nature is always close to our hearts. Yeah, it is indeed. We've got to protect nature, haven't we? What else we've got coming up here? We've got Eduardo says, good morning from Brazil. Good morning to you, Eduardo. Are you having breakfast still? Yeah, because it's lunchtime here in the UK, isn't it? But good morning and thank you for your messages. Do keep sending them in and we should get through as many as we can. Let's have a look at the message board here. Hello from Syria, Ahmad. Thank you for watching. Hello. Fernando says it's 9:30 in the morning in Argentina. Well, good morning to you in Argentina. Thank you very much for watching. We've got a hi from Georgia. So hello, sorry, can't say your name, but hello in Georgia. And what else we've got? And good night from Myanmar, because, of course, it's much later over there in Myanmar, isn't it? I hope you had a good day. It's probably evening time. Good time to sit down and, you know, watch this quiz and take part. And Chinna Kotler, sorry if I got your name wrong, says she's really excited about the quiz. So that's good. That's good. We'll have one more message and then we'll start the quiz, shall we? We've got good evening from India, from Ali. Good evening in India. So hello to everybody in India, wherever you are. Oh, Cambodia as well. Great. Hello there. Right. Even more messages coming in. I love nature so much from Sudan. So that's really good to hear. Right. Good. Good to know you like nature, and it's good to know you're watching all around the world. So welcome to our live quiz here on BBC Learning English on Facebook and YouTube. It's Rob here, as I said, not Dylan this week, but hopefully I'll do a good job for you. Okay, 8 questions to come. I think we should start with our first question. So let me just get this up on the screen here. Here it comes. Bear with me as I deal with the technology here. It's all live. It's all live. Okay. Round 1. I'm going to ring a bell each time, just like Dylan does. Yep. Ring the bell when it's a new round. Okay. Here we go. Round 1. Here is your first question coming up. Ah, look. There's an elephant there. Who likes elephants? I do. Gentle giants, aren't they? Right. Here is your first question. Let's make this a bit bigger for you to see. First question about nature is that human activity is making many species in danger, endangered, or endangered. Okay, so human activity is making many species in danger, endangered, or endangered. Okay, what is the answer? Do tell me, because your messages will come in on my screen here and I can hopefully share them with you. So this question about animal species, what's happening to them and what is the answer? Okay. Kayandato says A. Okay, good guess. Al says C. Very good, very good. Trang says A. Okay, so we've got mixed opinions here. Not everyone's sure what the answer is. So we've got A and C. Nobody said B yet. Nobody said B, have they? Zari says C. Amna is absolutely sure it is C. We will see later on, of course. What have we got here? Clizia says in danger. Nar says in danger. So a lot of you are saying A. Human activity is making many species in danger. But Joven here thinks it's C, endangered. Is the word endangered? I wonder. And I've had Amna, haven't we? She said C. Kem also says C. Okay. Tien says A. Okay. All right. I say, not everyone's quite sure what the answer is. Who else we've got coming in here? Ray says C. Okay. Right. Well, as I said, we'll give the questions out first of all, and I'll give you the answers later on. So please keep those messages coming in. Okay, this is the live quiz with me, Rob, here from BBC Learning English. Thank you very much for watching. Are we ready to ring the bell? Because that means we are going to move on now to another question. Round 2. Here comes round 2. And here is your question. Can you see that on the screen? I'll let you read that very briefly. It's to do with a little insect called a bee. I'm sure you're all familiar with bees, aren't you? Bzz, the buzzy bees that buzz around and land on the flowers, don't they? Pollinate the flowers. We should look after our bees. Everyone says we should look after bees. Do you agree? Do bees scare you? Because, of course, bees can sting, can't they? And this question, this nature-related question, is about a bee's sting, and it's all about where to put the apostrophe. So a bee sting can really hurt. I think we all agree with that. Ouch. Bees do sting and it does hurt. But if we're writing that down, where do we put the apostrophe? Is it A before the S, B no apostrophe at all, or C after the S? Before the S, no apostrophe, or after the S? What is everybody saying to this question? Let's have a look. Right. Azella says A. Okay, good try. Thank you for trying. Abbas says A. Evgeny here says he has a bee in his bonnet. That's a very good saying. If you've got a bee in your bonnet, you're a bit annoyed about something. You won't let it go. Oh, I've got a bee in your bonnet. Hopefully the bee in your bonnet won't sting you. Right, what are other people saying? What do you think the answer is? Come on, do tell me. Both thinks it's A, an apostrophe before the S. Lafa says a bee sting can really hurt. I agree. I've been stung and, oh, ow, it is so painful, isn't it? It really is painful. Azella says A. Yes, we've had Azella. Kem says A. Laxmi says A. Jasmine says B. And Narutu says A. Okay, keep guessing, keep trying. We've got a bit longer to try and work out the answer. Asia says bees with an apostrophe before the S. So that is answer A. Any more? Jan says A. Good. And Manisha says A. So a lot of you are saying A, but not everybody. Let's see what else we've got here. Pamela thinks C, the apostrophe after the S. And what else we've got? Hicham says A. And Ramin says A. So, you know, a lot of you are saying A. I agree. Another A there. Okay. Let's have another look. What else is coming in? Thank you for all your messages, by the way. Do keep them coming in. Even if you don't want to answer a question, just give me a comment like this one. I got a bee sting yesterday. I'm sorry to hear that. Did you put some cream on it? What did you do? Okay, so that's our second question on our live quiz. 8 questions today. We have a special guest coming up very soon as well. But that is question number 2. Time to ring. Ring the bell, because it is time to move on now to our next question, which is round three. And here is your nature related question coming up. Don't forget, by the way, to share, like and comment on this quiz. Tell me what you think. It'd be great to hear from you. Okay. Now, have we all heard of Mother Nature? Yeah, Mother Nature, a term we use for all of nature, really, and the force of nature. She's not a real kind of living mother, but it's a term we use. Mother Nature is amazing. And we want to say that as a statement. What do we say? Mother Nature is amazing, isn't she? Mother Nature is amazing, is she? Or Mother Nature is amazing, aren't she? Okay. So Mother Nature is amazing, A, isn't she? B, is she? Or C, aren't she? What do we say? What's the correct thing to say in English? What are you saying? Okay, well, Lien says, isn't she? We are talking about a mother, so I guess it's a she. That's a bit of a clue. But let's have a look. Jasmine says, A. Wow, okay. Thomas says, isn't she? Mustafa says, A. So that's, isn't she? Let's see who else we've got here. Ngoy says A, isn't she? So you all seem quite confident that it's A, isn't she? Not is she or aren't she? Are you sure? Are you sure about your answers? Okay, who else is answering? By the way, do tell me where you're watching from as well. I love to know where you're watching from. Okay. Svitlana says A, okay. Estella says A, and there's a nice flower there from Mother Nature. Yaz says A. Vet says A. Sadiqa says A. I think we can be quite confident that you think it's A. Mother Nature is amazing, isn't she? I wonder, though. I wonder if that's the correct answer. Well, you won't find out what the correct answer is until later on. Latha says Mother Nature is amazing, isn't she? Well, we'll find out if you're right later on. Do you agree? Is Mother Nature amazing? All those amazing bits of wildlife and natural things outside is amazing. We are talking about nature today on this live quiz. Please comment, like and share, and I will be giving you the answers later on. And it's not long before we have our special guest. Who is our special guest going to be today? Any ideas, anybody? Go on, tell me. Who do you think is going to be our special guest? Who will it be? Do you think it could be Dylan, or has he got the day off? I wonder. Right. Well, not long till we find out who our special guest is. But in the meantime, let's carry on. Yes, let's ring that bell. Yeah. Okay, cool. And let's move on now to round four, our fourth question out of eight. And here is your nature-related question. You read that? Yeah. What is it? An area of land where animals and plants are protected is called a nature A, trail, B, reserve, or C, study. An area of land where animals and plants are protected is called a nature A, a nature trail, B, a nature reserve, or C, nature study. What could it be? And have you been to one of these places? Right, what are you saying? What are you saying? Maya says B. Nidhi says B. Alka says a reserve, so that's B, a nature reserve. So a place where animals and plants are protected. Have you been to one of these places, maybe? Do you live near one? Is there one nearby? Do tell me. Okay, what else we got? So we've had Nidhi. Let's move on. Who else is answering? Right, okay. Pamela says B. Fauzia says B. Tom says B. Monsi says B. San says a reserve. Okay. What else? Chan Visna says B. Ramin says B. Okay, you're all quite confident that it's B, a nature reserve. That's an area of land where animals and plants are protected. Okay, Suwu says B as well. Oh no, we do have a different opinion now. Somebody has said, I'm sorry, I've just lost your message. We had an A there. Somebody said it's a nature trail. Okay. Any other answers coming in? Yes, we've got more B's coming in. Sofian says B. Okay. Another B there. So we have lots of B's. Let's try this one. Han says a reserve as well. So is it a nature reserve? We will find out later on when I give you the answers. Okay, right. Let's ring this bell because we're coming up now for round five. Round five coming up. And this is our time to find out who our special guest is. Who is our special guest going to be? Here she comes.
Hello. Hi, Rob. How are you?
Good, very good, thank you. And thank you for joining us on the quiz.
My pleasure. Hello, everyone.
How's your day going?
It's going well. It's Friday, Rob, so it's good. Going well. Good. How's yours?
It's going very well so far, anyway, so far. Now, of course, we're talking about nature today.
Yeah.
How do you feel about nature?
I love nature. Uh-huh. I live in London, so I don't get to see or be in nature very often. But when I get the chance, I try to leave London and go and spend some time in the countryside. So, yes, I'm a fan. I'm a nature lover.
That's good. Yes, London can be a bit of a concrete jungle, can't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Not much greenery. Okay. But it's important, of course, that we go to these green spaces and we need to protect them, don't you think?
That's right. And interestingly enough, that is my question for today. So would you like me to ask my question?
Yes, you've got a question about that. Yes, go ahead, please.
I do. So listen up, everyone. This is your question. You have three options. The question is, protecting wildlife and nature is called, number one, or letter A, sorry, conservation. Letter B, conservation. And letter C, conversation. So let me repeat those. Yeah. Protecting wildlife and nature is called letter A, conservation, letter B, conservation, and letter C, conversation. What do you think? Hi, Tom.
Tom says hello. Sam. Hi, Tom. Hello's coming through here.
Hello, hello. Nice to see you all. Hello, everyone. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday, yes. Happy People are very Friday. Pleased to see you here, Sam. Thank you for your question. So it's got to listen very carefully then. So is it A, conversation, B, conservation, or C, conversation?
Yeah, very similar sounding words, but only one of them is actually correct.
Okay. Oh, great. Well, thank you for that question. We'll give out the answer later, not now. And It is nearly the weekend. So what are you going to do this weekend then?
I am going to spend a lot of time outside London in nature. We have a 3-day weekend coming up here in the UK. So Monday is a national holiday. So I will not be here. I will be walking with friends and family outside, hopefully, if the weather is on our side. I'm not sure, but hopefully. Hmm.
Okay, good. Well, enjoy that.
Thank you.
Thank you for your question.
My pleasure. Have a good weekend, Rob and everyone else. Enjoy the rest of the quiz. Good luck.
Thanks, Sam. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.
Okay, great. Thank you for that question, Sam. Do you know the answer, anybody? So let me repeat the question again. Protecting wildlife and nature is called A, conversation, B, conservation, or C, conversation. So what are people saying? Of course, you've got to be able to spell it as well if you want to put it on the screen here. Okay, this is conservation. So that's answer B. Foud says B as well. So conservation was B, wasn't it? B was conservation. S in the middle there. Armit says conservation with a S. Yeah, good. Who else we got here coming through on the message board? Right, here we go. Sachin says conservation. Conservation. Okay, good. Penyapa says conservation. Good spelling. Well done. Mariana says conservation. Lots of bees coming in here. Are you sure it's not? You're sure it's not conversation? You sure? Or it's not conversation? The protection of wildlife is not conversation? Okay. Just checking. Ewa says conservation. Geraldine says conservation. What else we got? Another one here. Han says conservation. Oh, it didn't come on screen there, did it? Jan says conservation. And look, there was a lion there as well. So thank you very much for the lion. Got a C here. Oh, yes, C, right. So C, the option was conversation. Is it C, conversation? We'll give the answers later on. Let's take one more for now on this round. Desorn says conservation. Okay, right. Thank you for giving that a try. I will give the answers later on. Questions first, answers later. Keep trying, keep thinking about that word. How do we say it? Okay. Right. So this is our live quiz every Friday here from BBC Learning English. This week it's me, Rob, not Dylan. So nice to have you on board and watching. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to comment and to share and to like. Be really nice to know that you're out there watching and enjoying the quiz. How am I doing today? My first quiz. Do let me know. Right. Well, that was round 5. We're talking about nature today. So I'd like to know your thoughts about nature as well. Should we protect nature? Is Mother Nature amazing? Do tell us. Right, let's ring this bell and move on to our next round. And that is round 6, of course. Another nature-related question for you. And here it is. Oh, look at those cute animals. Oh, you can't see them, can you? Sorry. There you go. There they are. Round 6. Here's our cute animals. They are, of course, lemurs. Lemurs, which I think are from Madagascar, aren't they? Very cute. Now, this question is about collective nouns, and groups of animals have a collective noun names, like a herd of sheep, for example. But here we're talking about a group of lemurs. What is the collective noun for a group of lemurs? Is it A, gaggle, B, a troop, or C, a conspiracy? Strange, isn't it? So what is the collective noun for a group of lemurs? Is it A, a gaggle, B, a troop, or C, a conspiracy? A gaggle of lemurs, a troop of lemurs, or a conspiracy of lemurs? Do you know what that answer is? Please tell me right now. And Zhao says it's a gaggle of lemurs. Right. A, a gaggle. A gaggle. Geraldine says a gaggle of lemurs. Shafiza says a troop, B, a troop of lemurs. And then what are our answers we got coming through from you? Halla says a gaggle. Mikiti says a gaggle. Junko says a gaggle. And Maria is just being honest. I have no idea, she says. No idea. Have a guess. Have a guess. Ford says troop. Troop. Zari says B, a troop. A troop of lemurs. Ray, a troop of lemurs. Not many people going for C, a conspiracy of lemurs. Dennis says, can it be a troop? Well, I don't know. I'll tell you the answer later. You'll have to wait and see. What else we've got here? Okay. Areki says, see, a conspiracy of lemurs. Whatever they are, they're very cute, aren't they? Look at their little eyes. Hamza says, a troop. Dini says, be a troop. A lot of you seem to think it's a troop. A troop. Anybody else? Ah, somebody says, see. We've got Han saying a gaggle of lemurs. And Nora says, it is good to have a guess. I agree. It's a bit of fun. Don't worry if you get it wrong. Have a guess. A, B, or C. It's better to have a guess at something than say nothing at all. Right. What else have we got? Sinzia says, a gaggle. This has really stumped some of you, hasn't it? Jasmine says, a gaggle of lemurs. What else we got? Another Jasmine, that same Jasmine says a. And May says, I cannot guess. Okay, don't guess. I shall give you the answer later on. What is a collective noun for a group of lemurs? Tricky one, that one, wasn't it? Okay, answers coming up quite soon. We have two more questions to go, which means ring my bell on this live nature related quiz as we move on to round seven. Here we go, round seven. And it's about the Antarctic blue whale. Have you ever seen an Antarctic blue whale? Apparently, and this is a fact, it is the something animal on the planet. Is it the large animal on the planet, the most large animal on the planet, or the largest animal on the planet? The Antarctic blue whale is the large animal on the planet, the most large animal on the planet, or the largest animal on the planet. I haven't given you A, B, or C there, so you'll have to tell me the whole word, won't you? Come on, what do you think the answer is to this one? Whales are amazing, of course, and they are huge, but it's the Antarctic blue whale that is something. Right, what are we saying? Adam says the largest. Gulab says the largest. Fazia says the largest. Nora says the largest. Azra says the largest. Oh, that's gone, that one. What happened to that message? Honey says the largest. Anybody else? Anybody else for large or the most large animal on the planet? Miriam says B, the most large animal on the planet. Jun, you've done well. You've given me the whole sentence. The Antarctic blue whale is the largest animal on the planet. Right, okay. Yagut says large is a short word, so it will be largest. I like your thinking there. Very good. Estella says largest. What else we got going on here? So Gaffar says the largest. M, whoever M is, it says B. And what else are people saying? Come on, keep your answers coming in. Do tell me. Salwa, here we are. Salwa's message says largest. What else we got here coming in? Fatima says the largest. Roy says the largest. Everybody's saying the largest. But are you right? Are you right? I wonder. Jesse says it definitely is the largest. You seem very sure of yourself. Okay. Have you ever seen an Antarctic blue whale? Tell me if you've seen any whale in the wild. It would be good to tell me whilst we look at some more answers. Yusuf says largest. Okay. And let's see what else we've got. Tom says C. Okay. Erlem has given, Niazi says large. It's a small adjective, so it is accompanied with est, E-S-T. Right. Okay. We'll see if you're right. I've in the movies. Okay. You've seen whales in the movies. Okay. Like Free Willy, maybe. Okay. Oh, and what's this? It's got a message coming in there. I'm going to share this one with you, but I can't find it now because it's disappeared off my screen. Here we are. Mariam says, I have never seen whales, but pictures enough to be sure how great creatures they are. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Nice comment. Thank you. Okay, well, I'll give you the answer very soon. We have one more question to get through. Let's ring the bell because it is time now for our final question, round 8. Nature-related question because we're talking about nature today. And here it is. Here is your final question today. Have a look at that. See what you think. What do you think it could be? Question 8. Something to nature, it's a phrase, means living a simpler and more relaxed lifestyle. Right. So something to nature means living a simpler and more relaxed lifestyle. So is this phrase up to nature, B, back to nature, or C, down to nature? So is it A, up to nature, B, back to nature, or C, down to nature? It is a phrase that we use in English, meaning living a simpler and more relaxed lifestyle. So let's go to our comments and find out what you think. Is it up, back, or down? Right. Trang says A, up to nature. Mohammed says it's back to nature. Ford says it's B, back to nature. And Reem says it's B, back to nature. Okay. Noor says it's down to nature. So if you're going to change to a simpler, more relaxed lifestyle, do you get down to nature? Yong says back to nature. Okay. What else are people saying? Thet says B, back to nature. Okay. Vilma says B, back to nature. Irfan says C, down to nature. Anil says B, back to nature. Okay. Go on, have a guess if you're not sure. Sunil says back to nature. M, Damien, says back to nature. Saika says back to nature. Okay. Any other answers coming in? Do send me your answers. We've got lots of people saying back to nature, but not everybody is saying that. Ashish says down to nature. So C, down to nature. Shara doesn't know the answer, but it's given me lots of lovely nature symbols there. I like all of those. Thank you very much. Dwee says up to nature. Jasmine, yes, says back to nature. Come on, what do you think? What is the right answer? George says return to nature. I like your thinking, but that wasn't an option in this particular question. Return to nature. I know what you mean, but that's not the option today. Anjali says down to nature. Okay. Maribel says up to nature. So we're going up, down, and back. Well, which way is it? Which way is it? Sofiane says up to nature. I wonder if you're going to be right. Right, let's take one more answer. And then we'll go and reveal the answers. Ashish is down to nature, up to nature, back to nature. Okay, well, the opinion is divided. Okay, well, that is our last question. It's now time for... ding, ding, ding. Now time to reveal some of the answers. Let's find out how you got on, okay? Don't worry if you got them wrong. This is all about having fun, having a go, testing your English knowledge. Okay, right. Shall we go to our first question, which was, you remember this elephant? Yes. The question was, human activity is making many species A, in danger, B, endangered, or C, endangered. All right. Are you ready for the answer? Let's see if you were right or wrong. The correct answer is C. Endangered, all one word, and this is because it's an adjective. Okay, an endangered animal or a plant will soon become extinct. It won't exist anymore. They're basically, something that is endangered is at risk. It might not live for much longer. So we can say that an animal like an elephant is in danger. There's a risk to it, but the adjective is endangered. Okay, so human activity is making species endangered. Endangered, that is the answer. Answer C, okay? The adjective endangered. So how did you do? I want to know how you did. So please tell me if you were right or wrong. Let's have a look and I'll put your name up on the screen. Okay. Somebody said C, so they were correct. Okay, nice symbol there. Manuel says endangered species is the being human. I think you mean human being currently. So you're thinking human beings are endangered, do you? Okay, well, you used the word endangered correctly there, so well done, well done. Who else got it right? Let's have a look. Wrong for Shara. I chose A. It doesn't matter. Don't worry. I won't tell anybody. Shh. We'll keep it a secret. It's just about having a go and having fun. Monsi says, I got it right. So well done. Well done. What else we got? Tom. No, we've got M. Damien. It's a new adjective for you. So well done. You've learned something today. David's got 1 out of 1. Well done. 1 out of 1 is great. Let's see who else is there. Shatintha says, I got it correct. So well done. Anna says, I chose the first wrong one, A. You were wrong. Doesn't matter. There's more questions or more answers to come. And Sharon said, C, endangered. So well done. The answer was endangered. So give yourself a clap if you got that right. Let's move on now to the answer for question two. Remember, we talked about bees. Buzzy bees, a something sting can really hurt. Well, we knew it was a bee sting, but is it a bee's sting with an apostrophe before the S? B, bees, or C, bees with an apostrophe after the S? Well, I can reveal the correct answer here was A, bees with an apostrophe before the S. This is a question about, it's all about possessive apostrophes. So it's telling you what something belongs to. And in this case, we're talking about one B. Okay. And therefore the apostrophe goes before the S, a bee's sting. Okay. So just to tell you again, an apostrophe can be used to show that one thing belongs to its, to something else, to something it's connected to. So here the sting belongs to the bee. Now apostrophes have many uses. And there are, of course, many rules, as always. So do check out our website at bbclearningenglish.com for a full description of how to use apostrophes, okay? But here we're talking about a possessive apostrophe for one bee, and the sting belongs to the bee. So it's a single thing, okay? Now, if the word ended in an S, stings, then we put it after the S. But I say there are a lot of complicated rules about this, so it's best to check out our website. The answer here was A. So how did people do with the answers? Let's have a look to see what you're telling me. Okay, so Shafisa got 2 out of 2, so well done. Excellent, excellent. M. Damien got both A and C. Okay, but it was answer A. Sake said, I got it right, so well done to you. Syed said, it is correct. Good. Chesminur said, I guessed right, so well done. Who else got it right? Let's have a look. Evgeny got it right too, so well done. Sachintha says, yes, again, I got it right, 2 out of 2, so well done. Good, excellent. And who else? Let's see. Yi, yes, got this right, well done. And Zhao says, clap for myself, blah, blah. Clap for yourself. I'll clap for anybody who's got 2 out of 2. So well done, well done. Even if you didn't get it right, it's all about taking part and having fun. Right, I think we should move on quickly to question number 3. Do you remember this question about Mother Nature? Mother Nature is amazing, isn't she? Is she or aren't she? Well, the correct answer was A, isn't she? Mother Nature is amazing, isn't she? This is all about question tags, isn't it? Question tags, they work by turning a statement into a question by adding a tag at the end. And the main thing to remember is that the tag is a short kind of yes or no question. So here it's, isn't she? Short question. And we use the tags depending on the statement. So question tags can be negative or positive. If the statement part is positive, then the tag is negative. So here, Mother Nature is amazing. Positive is followed by a negative question tag. Isn't she? Okay, get that? So if the statement is negative, the question tag is positive. Okay, but here it's the other way around. And the answer is A, isn't she? So how did you get on? Let's go back to the comments and find out how you got on. Okay. Tin says, correct, so well done. Mine got 3 out of 3, so well done. Yamileth said, isn't she? That's A, so you're correct as well. Jao's got 2 out of 3 so far, so not bad at all. Yay, you say. Elisabetta says, isn't she? Good. Hamidar has got 3 out of 8, so well done, well done, good work, glad to hear it. Who else we got here? Georgie says A, so you got that right, well done. Fernando said correct, and yeah, good, says yes, 3 out of 3, I got it, yeah, you smashed it, well done. Excellent, excellent, well done to anybody who got that right. By the way, if you just joined us, this is the live Friday quiz from BBC Learning English. We've had the questions. We're now doing the answers. 8 answers there are in total. We're going now to the answer for question 4. Another, excuse me, a nature-related question. The question was, an area of land where animals and plants are protected is called a nature A, trail, B, reserve, or C, study. Have you been to one of these places? A place where animals and plants are protected is a nature reserve. That's right, a nature reserve. This is the noun. And a reserve is an area of land. And in particular, where nature and wildlife is looked after is a nature reserve. Okay, it's protected in order to keep the animals and plants that live there and make sure they're not destroyed and they don't become extinct or endangered. Okay, so it's an area where plants, animals are specially protected. An area is a reserve. Okay, and that is the answer. B, reserve. All right, good. So how did we do on that question? Was it quite easy, do you think? Let's have a look. Nor says, I guess B, so you were correct. Mogron got it as well, so well done. Alida says 2 out of 4 so far, so that's not bad at all. Ben Yappa got the answer right. Good. Yolanda says an area is a reserve, so a nature reserve. A trail is more of a walk through nature, a pathway. Maybe you follow it on a map, but it's a trail going through nature. A nature study, of course, is something you go away and study something for a report or an exam or something like that. But a nature reserve is an area. Okay, what else are people saying? Ashish got B, well done. Mayan's got 4 out of 4, so that's fantastic. Makiti is asking about a trail. Yes, a nature trail is a route or a path through something. And if it's a nature trail, it's a particularly a route or a path through a piece of nature, maybe through a forest or a meadow or something like that. It's actually a route you follow, not just an area, but the route itself. Okay, what else? Let's have a look. Okay, Targol says, I didn't know. Fine, you've learned something today, which is great. Irfan's got 3 out of 4, very good. Mohammed's got 4 out of 4, so that's good news as well. You're doing well. This is interesting. Archan says, we have a tiger reserve in India, so you have an area, probably quite a large area, where rare tigers are protected. There's probably a fence around the out of it just to make sure they don't escape, and also people don't come in and damage them. So you have a tiger reserve. That's very interesting. Thank you very much. And Yagot again, yeah, 4 out of 4. It was easy, I think. Yeah, good. So I'm glad you got 4 out of 4. Not everybody has. Doesn't matter. It's just about taking part and having fun, isn't it? There's no prizes apart from watching me for an hour. Okay. Let's go to number 5 now. Do you remember this question from Sam? Sam was our special guest. She came on and talked about wildlife and going out into the nature, And here the question was, protecting wildlife and nature is called, was it A, conversation, B, conservation, or C, conversation? You probably know what the word is, but it's all about getting the spelling and the pronunciation that, and how you say it. Right. Well, the answer was, of course, B. The answer was conservation. How did you do? How did you do? I can hear people going, yes, easy. Let's find out. Okay. Aditya says it's B. Yosk said right. Anisha said B, so you were correct. Khan says B. Excellent. Mohammed has got 5 out of 5, so well done, aren't you clever? Farm says B. Makiti says got it, well done. Hildora says B. Ford, you've got 5 out of 5, so brilliant, well done. Maria's got B and is giving herself a clap, well done. Another B there. Who else? Patricia has got 5 out of 5, so well done. Yubra just got 4 out of 5. Sorry if I'm not getting your names said correctly. And Francois has got 5 out of 5. Can I be the English teacher? Well, not at the moment, it's my turn, but maybe another time. Okay. Good, you got it. You got bees, excellent. And Yi says, what does it mean, conversation? Well, a conversation is nothing to do with wildlife or nature, it's to do with talking. When two people talk, they have a conversation, they talk about something, they converse, and they are having a conversation. So, there you go. Good question, thank you, Yi. Right. Okay. That was question 5. Let's move on to the answer now for question 6. Do you remember these cute little things? Lemurs. Yes. But what is the collective noun for a group of lemurs? Gaggle, troop, or a conspiracy? And the answer was, surprisingly for some, a conspiracy. Yeah. A collective noun for a group of lemurs is a conspiracy. Did you know that? I didn't know that actually until I did some research. A conspiracy. Okay, what can I tell you about a conspiracy? Well, it's obviously a collective noun for a group of lemurs. A gaggle is a name for a group of geese. You get a gaggle of geese. And did you know a troop is a collective noun for a group of kangaroos? A troop of kangaroos. So a gaggle of geese, troop of kangaroos, conspiracy of lemurs. Have you learned something today? Hopefully you'll remember that. What are people saying? Gautami says, oh, a bit shocked there. Yayi says, I was wrong. Mayan's got 6 out of 6. So you knew that, did you? Sandra said, yeah, I don't know. Didn't know the answer to that one. VG says, my answer is wrong. Fatima says, it's wrong. I chose B. Only 5 out of 8. So that's still a very good score. Sandra says, I don't know. What else we got here? C, a conspiracy. You got that right. Well done. Ritaraj said, I got it. And Monty says, I got it wrong. Don't worry. It was quite a tricky question, wasn't it? And again says, I've learned as much as I can. Chinsia, I chose A. And Niazi says, we didn't expect that at all. No, I know. It's amazing, isn't it? Never mind. Never mind. Somebody's asking, why is it called a conspiracy? I really don't know. That's just a name that has evolved for a group. Maybe they're conspiring. Maybe it's because they look like they're conspiring to do something. There you go. Mogron said, I had no idea. But Tom said, I got it right again. Well, well done for you, Tom. Fantastic. Okay, how are we getting on? Let's go on to question number 7 about the whales. Remember this one. The Antarctic blue whale is the large animal on the planet, the most large animal on the planet, or the largest animal on the planet. The correct answer was largest. Yes, the Antarctic blue whale is the largest animal on the planet. How did you get on with that one? Was that really easy peasy or not? We'll find out in a minute. I'll just tell you, this is about superlative adjectives, in fact, and they highlight something that is bigger or better or more than something else. It's the most of something, okay? A superlative adjective. And we usually, generally speaking, we usually add EST after the adjective. So here we've added just S and T because the word ended in E, but it's largest, EST, and we use the before the adjective. So notice we've written the largest animal. So you need a the before it, and we add EST to make it the largest or the biggest or the smallest, simplest, fattest. Okay, it's got an EST on the end. Okay. Now, of course, there are other rules as well, and they're all on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. But generally speaking, just as a guide, you put the before the adjective and add EST. Okay. So how did you do on that one? Let's have a look at your comments coming in. Whoa, Mayan's got 7 out of 7. I got it right. Zoot. Okay, very good. ICS said largest. Foud said, yippee, I've got 6 out of 7. Very good, very good. Tom's got it right again. Well done. Sazia has got 7 out of 7 as well. So well done. Tahani says, yes, I assume that means you got it right. Musa says largest. So well done. Zari says super easy, right? Not for everybody, but hopefully for you. Sofiane says correct. You got it right. So well done. Well, here's a good expression. It is a piece of cake, meaning it's very easy. Okay, good. M. Damien was wrong. Never mind. Simran said largest. So well done. Zimmi said largest as well. Amal just says hello from Jordan. So hello to you in Jordan. Khan says this quiz is kind of easy. Well, you know, not for everybody, but if you found it easy, that's good. You know your English well. And yeah, ICS says very good. So any more comments coming in about your scores so far? Let's have a look. Mohammed says 7 out of 8. That's a good score. And Lilia says, I was correct. So well done. Well done if you got it right. Don't worry if you got it wrong. It's all about having a go and having fun. Right, let's go to our last question. And I asked you, something to nature means living a simpler and more relaxed lifestyle. So this is an English phrase we use. Is it up to nature, back to nature, or down to nature? The answer was, of course, back to nature. Have you heard of that expression? Well, we want to lead an easier, simpler life, maybe not without smartphones and TVs, which are a simple life. We say that we're going back to nature. Back to nature is the phrase. How did you get on with that? Who got that right? Let's have a look. Bashar got 7 out of 8. Rumi got 7 out of 8. Ines got 6 out of 8. Elizabetta back to 6 out of 8. That's a good score, though. That's a good score. Luke says, yeah, I'm correct. Goy got 6 out of 8. Well done. Marchana said C on that one, so you got that one wrong. What else? Neng said back, so back to nature. What else? What else? Come on. How did you do? How did you do? Give me your scores. William says, like Back to the Future. It's a bit like that famous film, Back to the Future. Maybe they should do a new film and call it Back to Nature. And Yusuf got 7 out of 8. And Nora got, Loniwati got 6 out of 8. Laura didn't know the answer. Don't worry. And Targos, I didn't know, but thank you. Good. I hope we've explained something. And I felt like back to school learning things. Very good. Back to nature. Nice pictures there, Damien. And thank you, Evgeny. He says, thank you very much for the lesson. You are very welcome. My first live quiz here on Facebook and YouTube from BBC Learning English. And you know what? We've reached the end of our quiz. So well done if you got any of them right. It's good to have a go. We hope you've enjoyed the quiz. And don't forget, we'll be here with another quiz next Friday at 1:30 British time. It might be the morning in Brazil or the evening in Myanmar, but please join us for 8 more questions on a theme. And don't forget, we're all over social media with other live lessons, pronunciation live we've got. We've got this quiz, of course. And of course, we've got our website for more information about the English language. Just go to bbclearningenglish.com. But I think I should really say a big thank you for watching and taking part and for all your messages. It's been great to have you along on this live quiz. Hopefully you've learned something. Hopefully you've had fun and you've made friends. So thanks, teacher. Thank you. Have a nice weekend. Have a nice weekend, everybody. And I shall see you again very soon. Take care and thank you so much for taking part. All right. Okay. Bye for now. Bye. Have a great time. See you.